Hi, I'm Joe Simpson, and I'm here to talk to you today about the new P-Series range. I've been lucky enough to test the new P-Series for the last couple of months. Having been on a P3 for the last 4 or 5 years, it's been really exciting riding this new bike in a bunch of different setup options. The new P3 comes in at a slightly shorter reach than it has previously, so for you dirt jumpers, pump track riders who are after that short, snappy handling bike, that's going to be the one you need. I chose the P4 and the longer frame mainly for my height, but also for how I use it. I'm mainly at the dirt jumps, skate parks as well, but I'm also racing speed and style at crankworks and dual slalom, so the longer bike made a bit more sense for me. I would recommend it for taller riders like myself or anybody who's more comfortable on a downhill or a trail bike. P and P series really could stand for personalisation. There's so many options with either chassis for wheel size and what you want to do with it. On both these bikes, the chainstay length is exactly the same, but with options now to run 26 or 27.5 wheels on either bike. The new dropouts offer 15mm of chainstay adjustment in both single speed and geared options. The beauty with the 148 rear end means if you've got an old set of trail wheels and even an old 27.5 trail fork, you can lower the fork down to 100mm, you've pretty much got it yourself a dirt jump bike. The P3 comes complete with 26-inch wheels and the P4 with 27.5, however both bikes come as a frame only option which you can lace up with either wheel size. If you have any questions about bike setup, wheel sizes, anything like that, please drop a comment below or go see your local specialised dealer. Thing rips.